Now let's come to the most challenging question which we come across during our promotion of Valimixin. When the doctor says that I cannot use Valimixin without any published human studies. So we can answer it this way. We can, sir, I understand your concern, but it may take some time for us to provide a published human clinical evidence. Our research team is currently also working with multiple global investigators, experts and regulators for designing an effective clinical study protocol to evaluate the safety potential of Valimixin using novel early kidney injury biomarkers, and also to check the study feasibility. And once these things are done, we will be starting with a trial at a global level, probably by early 2022. However, following could be the reasons which could in a way justify you to consider Valimixin in your patients. First of all, sir, Valimixin is a novel formulation, but it's not a novel chemical entity. The supramolecular complex of polymyxin B in Valimixin is a delivery system which deals with the chemistry of non-covalent bonds between molecules and ionic species. The complex is formed by electrostatic interactions, and only there is no alteration in chemical structure of polymyxin B here. Further, sir, there are strong preclinical evidences. As it has been proven through a series of preclinical studies that without altering efficacy of polymyxin B, the associated renal toxicities have been reduced in the Valimixin formulation. In brief, in vitro cytotoxicity study in human and rat kidney cell line demonstrated that no formulation of polymyxin B reduced the toxicity by up to 60%. The nephrotoxicity was also assessed in animal studies through histopathology, traditional biomarkers like creatinine and urea, and novel early kidney injury biomarkers which are validated by FDA and EMA like KIM-1 and cystatin C. It was found that renal damage was significantly low in the Valimixin with respect to conventional polymyxin B, and the results have been presented in world's top conferences based in Europe and US like ECMAT and World Microbe Forum by American Society of Microbiology. Early this year, another research paper related to reduction in nephrotoxicity was published in Antibiotic Journal, which is having an impact factor of 4.6. Other animal studies also have highlighted both the pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics, that is efficacy parameters of this novel formulation, which remains same and unaltered. Further, doctor, there's another very important study which has just recently been concluded, is on approximate model. Human approximate modeling is the most advanced near physiological human kidney proximate tubule 3D model developed by Professor Colin Brown from New Cells Biotech UK. In fact, Dr. Brown, sir, is a recognized leading expert worldwide on renal drug toxicity and transport with over 30 years experience in this field. And approximate model is the most well characterized and most predictive human kidney injury assay available in the world as on date. Recently, he investigated the nephrotoxic potential of Valimixin versus Polymyxin B in this model using fresh human kidney cell lines from three human donor transplant kidneys. And the results proved that Valimixin reduces Polymyxin B induced kidney injury significantly. And data is on file, and the results will be published in another 3-4 months. Further to this, sir, Valimixin already has provided benefit of more than 5,000 patient days to critically ill in the leading tertiary care centers across the country for last 1 year, and the results had been quite satisfactory as per your colleagues. And another point is that you already know us for almost 10 years now. We at VMRC have a team of around 60 scientists with expertise covering nearly all domains of drug development. And as you know, we are working in the field of antimicrobial resistance for almost a decade now. We have a history of bringing newer innovative solutions for countering various unmet medical needs, and recognized with more than 100 patents over the years. Further, Doctor, even WHO's 2020 annual review on current antibacterial development from India features VMRC's 5 out of total 15 new drug candidates. Then we can say, Doctor, now you have a choice that whenever you come across any patient with HAP, VAP or sepsis, would you still like to consider going for conventional polymyxin B, which offers a narrow therapeutic window, confronting you with a dilemma of augmenting the dose exposure to improve bactericidal effectiveness and simultaneously also increasing the risk of acute kidney injury, which could further correlate to worsening the outcomes? Or would you consider going for an innovative valimixin therapy, which offers relative renal safety than the conventional regimen, and also even giving you an option to optimize the dose up to 25,000 or 30,000 IU per kg per day levels? So this way we are not, of course, not able to offer human studies as of now, but hum is tarah se step by step logics ke saath hum agar explain karenge jo key features valimixin offer kar raha hai clinicians ke liye, to ek possibility ban sakti hai ki doctors apne un patients mein use karna chahe valimixin jahan pe wo abhi tak polymyxin B use kar rahe the, kyunki as such agar hum dekhe to polymyxin B aur valimixin mein डिफरेंस ब्रॉडली यही है कि वेलीमिक्सिन में चांसेस हैं कि वो रीनल सेफ्टी ऑफर कर सकती है उनके पेशेंट में, जो कि उनके हिसाब से ह्यूमन स्टडीज़ में अभी तक प्रूव नहीं हुई है। तो अगर ह्यूमन में प्रूव नहीं हुई है, एनिमल्स में प्रूव हो चुकी है, इन विट्रो स्टडीज़ में प्रूव हो चुकी है, अब हमारे पास ह्यूमन किडनी का डेटा भी है जहाँ पे वो प्रूव हो चुकी है, एंड मे बी इन अनदर 6 months वी माइट स्टार्ट विद अ ग्लोबल ह्यूमन स्टडी ऑल्सो विच विल प्रोवाइड दैट काइंड ऑफ ह्यूमन एविडेंस। बट उस समय तक अगर कोई पेशेंट डॉक्टर के पास आता है जहाँ पे लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग सिचुएशन है, तो ये लॉजिकल बनेगा कि एक ऐसा ड्रग जो कि पॉसिबल सेफ्टी ऑफर कर रहा है और जिसका कॉस्ट में कोई डिफरेंस नहीं है टू द पेशेंट, तो ऑफ कोर्स एक ये लॉजिकल रीज़न बनता है डॉक्टर्स के लिए यूज़ करने के लिए अपने पेशेंट्स में। तो होपफुली ये आपको हेल्प करेगा इस तरह से आंसर करना अपने डॉक्टर्स में और कन्वर्ट करने में उनको। तो आप हमें फीडबैक अपने ज़रूर दीजिएगा कि कैसा रहा, कैसा डिस्कशन के बाद क्या आउटकम्स आए।